Chael Sonnen. It's good to see you.
It's good to be seen.
If you don't know, you should know. My name is Chael Sonnen, UFC middleweight champion, best of all time, and before time was even created.
Remember this, when you're the best fighter in the world today, they got a name for you. They don't call you a great fighter, they call you Chael Sonnen.
I hear guys talk about game plans and footwork and strategy with their coaches and their gold teeth and their eighth grade educations, and I don't care about any of that. I am, you know, Mark Munoz is going to find out, and I do like him, but never piss off a gangster.
Vandalay, you are an immigrant from Brazil. I am a gangster from America. Are you sure you want to play that game with me?
In some parallel universe, you can hit a man 300 times, he wraps his legs around your head for 8 seconds, and they call him the winner. On the streets of Westland, Oregon, that is not the rules. I am the middleweight champion. I defended my championship tonight for the first time, and I am willing to give Anderson a shot at the true belt, the linear belt, the people's belt from the best damn middleweight there's ever been.
All this handshaking and hugging and bowing, that's all crap. He's just battling the air. You know, he looks like he's at a dance club. That's not very tiring.
There was one point where he hid behind the referee that I thought was very funny, but I was in a
room full of people at a bar and they all booed him. And I'm like, that's actually a very funny move that he's doing right there. And then he did it again where the referee had to push him. Nobody, I'm alone.
The Japanese circuit is fake. It's always been fake. None of those guys won those fights. They never won those fights. Vanderlei Silva, 22-0. Mirko Krokop, one leg cemetery, one leg, you know, whatever. But what happened, Mirko? What happened to your legs? Nothing happened. The referee's not wearing an earpiece. The promoter didn't come in the back and tell your opponent when to go down. That's what happened. I lost my motivation. No, you didn't. You suck. You suck just like Fedor sucks. You suck just like Vanderlei sucks. Big difference when that referee's real, isn't it, Ariel? Medium very carefully when I talked about Brazil. I went to the internet. And if I had the foggiest idea that they had computers in Brazil, I wouldn't have done that.
You know the plight for the blue-eyed German male in this country. You guys have no idea what I'm up against. It's repression all over the place, but I struggle through. I'm here, your humble servant, ready for my first question.
You know, Vitor Belfort calls me out. That's no problem, Vitor. I will stomp you just as sure as I'll do this interview today. You mean nothing to me, okay? You want to fight me? Let's fight. Got that, Vitor? You challenge me, I accept your challenge, stupid. Now what are you going to do? Nothing, are you? You just said it because you knew my plate was full.
Yeah,
wrong. I will stomp you.
Well, I forgive Vitor. He's a fool. He knows not what he says. He can't hold a fool accountable because he got a little stupid in the media one time. Maybe you could give Vitor a couple of messages for me. First off, if my name comes out of his mouth again, I will bury him where he stands. And second off, tell Vitor to meet me at the hotel in 30 minutes because Daddy's got a plane to catch and I'm summoning him to carry my luggage.
He's saying that I'm a fake and a liar. Well, you know what? When we're inside the octagon, he's going to have to back up all these things he's saying about me.
He doesn't have enough skills to beat Anderson up, you know? I mean, if he stands up with Anderson, he's dead.
Oh, he tagged him!
Again, he got him! Rocked him!
He hurt him again!
Left hand! Wow! And again!
Oh,
he rocked him! He hurt him! Big shot by Chael Sonnen!
Ariel Helwani post-fight at UFC 109 with the new number one middleweight contender, Chael Sonnen. How does that sound, Chael?
That sounds pretty good, man. I'm feeling horrible right now, so I'll take anything to perk me up a little bit.
Yeah, you're pretty banged up. Have you ever been this banged up before?
No. I got cut in the fight. I got knocked out in the fight. I got choked in the fight. It was a miserable 15 minutes.
Now, I want to take you back to UFC 98.
Okay.
You defeated Dan Miller. You were at the post-fight press conference, and I remember not one person until the very end asked you a question.
Yep.
And you thanked them for asking you that question. When the press conference was over, no one wanted to talk to you. You were just kind of ignored.
Sure.
Now here you are. You got all the questions, more than Randy Couture. The spotlight is on you. This has to feel amazing.
I never even thought of that until you said it, but you're right. That is a compliment. I didn't realize I had, but you're right. I did get some good attention today.
Okay, so what went right out there for you? Everyone, you know, no one really believed when you said that you were just a better all-around fighter than Nate, but you proved it out there. Why did it work so well?
I'll tell you, people don't know what UFC stands for. The athletes are forgetting. It's the F that's confusing everybody. Some guys think this is the ultimate mitt-hitting championships. They think it's the ultimate high-altitude training championships. The ultimate let-me-go-away-in-seclusion and eat all the right food for 30 days championships. This is the ultimate fighting championship. And while these guys are out there swinging a sledgehammer and flipping a tire around, I'm throwing fists at a partner's head, neck, and chest. I'm fighting in practice every day, and I don't mean that, you know, we're sparring hard. I just mean I'm working on fighting things. I'm not spending my time on mental health and Anthony Robbins and screaming the word yes over and over. Not that that's bad. I'm just saying I'm not spending my time on that. If I'm going to work on fighting, I'm going to work on fighting. And when you get in a fight, that comes in very handy.
How close were you to tapping out when he had the guillotine choke in there?
I would never have tapped, but I was very close to going to sleep. I was on my way out.
What do you tell yourself?
If you get a chance, which one do you want to fight?
Because it's your first day on the job, Chael will stick around, John. I have no preference. I got the biggest arms. I got the greatest charm, and I do all the harm. One-on-one, two-on-one, or five-on-one. I'll make them all need 9-1-1.
Wanderlei Silva, 6 feet tall and 205 pounds. Boy, until I met you, I didn't know they could stack crap that high.
But I don't know the date. Can you just tell me the date?
You want to know? You want to know?
Come on, I just talking.
You
want to
know? You want
to
know?
I'm just asking. Wanderlei,
stop. You want to know? You want to know? You want to know?
Stop.
You want to know?
You want
to
stop.
You want to know?
Please stop. I can't let you get close.
Can you hear my
Stop. Stop.
Yeah, I've stayed away from him. I haven't seen Wanderlei until just now, and I don't even know if I made eye contact with him here. I have no idea. I mean, he came out in an interview and said he wanted to taste my blood, and it's like, come on, man. Dan Henderson knocked the taste out of your mouth 10 years ago. You can't taste a goddamn thing.
It annoys me because I feel like Wanderlei got his way. I mean, do you understand, Errol? You and everybody else waited in the weather. You came to the press conference. Wanderlei, it looks like he found a bathroom as a backdrop in the men's shelter he's living at in Rio and got somebody to point a cell phone at his face. I find it a little bit weird. You act like you just asked him a question. You just talked to Pexiglass with a little bit of technology in it, and then he gave you an answer. You understand we're beaming him in via satellite, Ariel. We could have used that satellite technology to point it somewhere in the world, depict and predict weather patterns, and protect people's lives. Instead, we've got Wanderlei Silva coming to us from a men's shelter bathroom in Brazil. Yeah, man, I find it a little bit weird. My mic. Let's just talk about that for the second. First off, I made Tito Ortiz scream tap in less than 60 seconds. And while I suspect that you're going to be tougher than him, I still get you out of there inside of the first round. And before I get accused of hogging the mic, Wanderlei, every time you talk, all I hear is garble, garble, garble. And I want to remind you, when you address me in public, you will do it proper. It's garble, 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 Mr. Sonnen. Yeah, it may be. I mean, I don't give a damn either way. It's an ass-whipping contest for 15 minutes of my life or until he gives up. So, yeah, I think there's some truth to that, but these are press conferences. You got to bring some attention. Listen, I told the press 3 weeks ago, the next time I see Wanderlei Silva, I'm going to be fighting Wanderlei Silva, and he stayed home in Brazil, and that's just the reality. And the last time I saw Wanderlei Silva, I fought Wanderlei Silva on the streets of Brazil. So, yes, my words matter. My words care. We are back on pay-per-view, and Daddy is the king of pay-per-view. I'm not coming into the men's bathroom at the homeless shelter, Wanderlei. You can call me out all you want. I told you I'd be in New York, and I will be in New York on June 24th, one place you are not. Mr. Sonnen.
Here in the U.S.
Excuse me. Mr. Sonnen, excuse me. Could you imagine the excitement that Fedor must have right now? Could you imagine how bad he wants to reach out and touch the largest arm in Westland, Oregon that is sitting right next to him? Instead, people keep going to Wanderlei Silva. You want to hear it from Wanderlei Silva? You want to know how you could get as much tantalizing conversation from something as Wanderlei Silva? Just talk to my shoe. Just ask the shoe. What's it going to be like, shoe? What's it going to be like to walk into Madison Square Garden in front of a sold-out arena with the biggest box office in history because Bellator called the king? And you know what Wanderlei's going to say? Oh, garble, garble, garble. It's garble, 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 Mr. Sonnen! Do you see the genius at work? Do you see how I did that? And while Vandalay hides out in the bathroom in Rio, when all is said and done, I will promise you this. It's going to be one more in the win column, one more for the highlight reel, and one more for the bad guy.
Go ahead. Tell him what I do so well.
Well, he talks well. His mouth has gotten him every fight, big fight that he's had. And every time when it's time to present and perform, he's failed. On Saturday night, it's not going to change. What I do well, I come in with heart. I come in with determination. I come in with hard work and perseverance. When I get my hand raised, I'll know why. And so all the millions of fans that have had my back over the last 20 years.
Tito always says I'm using my mouth to get my opportunities. The only person I know that made money using their mouth is his ex-wife.
Well, just to correct you, I was never no marriage. You're a fucking punk, dude. that's what you call class right here compared to no class.
That was a nasty line.
No
by
class.
Me.
No class at all. That's why you see him with thongs and fucking jeans and a t-shirt. No class.
They don't call you the bad guy for nothing.
How'd you get like this?
I'm from the mean streets of Westland, Oregon. You got to look over your back. You don't know what it's like out there. I'll tell you about it someday, but it's rough.
I just imagine it being a lot of ducks.
A lot of ducks? Oh, I'm sorry. Is this where I laughed? Was that your attempted humor? I'm sorry. I would have played a lot. I didn't know that. Was that supposed ducks.
Well, are you going to give me? Or are you going to tell?
Top Gun. Top Gun is out. And guys, can I ask you a favor? Please don't pretend like you love Top Gun. Could you please stop doing that? Because it's not true. You might enjoy this new Top Gun. I haven't seen it yet. I definitely will. They'll get my money. Tom Cruise might be a crazy man. He's one of my favorite actors of my entire life. So I'm not a hater, is what I'm sharing with you. But please don't pretend to me that you loved Top Gun. Please don't pretend to me that that influenced your junior high or your high school or your lifetime at all. Please don't share with me that you sat and crossed your fingers to whatever movie gods are out there that they would make a remake of Top Gun.
Joe, I don't promote fights. I pick fights. I'm better than John Jones. I'm better than Sean Combs. I am even better than John Holmes.
John Holmes is a dead junkie, and Sean Combs is like a rapper. Is that the other guy?
Don't bring up old business. The course is current events. FX Ultimate Fighter just before Justified Tuesday night.
A lot of people talk to me about giving up some size to Babalu. You know, I push people Babalu size out of the way looking for somebody to fight.
John Jones has 12 pounds of gold, and it belongs to me. It's going to come down to who's tougher. Whoever's tougher is going to win this fight, and I know he admires my toughness.
Joe Rogan, tonight is not for questions for me. This is your night, brother. I want to know how you feel being only inches away from greatness. I want you to tell everybody how it feels. Are you not mesmerized? Do you not have chills going up your spine?
I'm here to be the king of the mountain, or I'll move on in life and do something else. I think I can beat any man God ever made.
What did you see when you watched that fight?
Look, Floyd needs to keep doing what he's doing, which is fighting complete tomato cans who we've never heard of before. I've never seen anybody in the history of America get so rich and so famous out of having complete wimps throwing punch at their faces. And I know what you're saying. You're saying, well, it's happened before. What about Rihanna? Shame on you. Classless. I will not stand for that. I will not stand.
Yeah, well, you know what?
But I'm from Oklahoma. Born and raised, wrestling for years and years.
God's country, good man.
Absolutely. I think Daniel Cormier actually deserved that shot, though. And I actually fought Kelvin Gastelum right before he went on The Ultimate Fighter. And over the last 2 years, as a fighter, though, and you're a wrestler, and I always liked you because you were a wrestler. Regardless, but I keep trying to figure out why people keep asking for your opinion when you have not had your hand raised in almost 2 times. You won was against Bisping, and that's real talk, dude. Like, don't get me wrong, Dana keeps you around because you're a Fox commentator. Real talk, because you can sell tickets, because that's Dana's job. But Oklahoma, Daniel Cormier, Johnny Hendricks, Mark Munoz will be fighting tonight. Mola Wall, we're all from Oklahoma. The man that's running this tournament back here, Jack Roller, Oklahoma.
Spit it out, brother. You're putting everybody to sleep, man. I'm about to come down there and whip your ass in a second. Just to get people to real talk, stupid. Speak English. I don't speak ghetto. I don't even know a real topic. Here's real talk, dummy. If you don't get to the end of the line, I'm going to come down there and warm up on you before I take care of LeBron later tonight. So take those stupid sunglasses off your head. Because when it's not true, dummy.
I don't sell memberships.
You don't sell anything, stupid.
I sell ass whippings. I don't sell memberships.
You sell ass whippings? What is your name again? Who are you?
Bill Smallwood.
All I've heard is you're from Oklahoma. Those guys are from Oklahoma State. Every name that you just dropped, let me hand them back to you because they're not even from where you said they're some, stupid. And tell my room of fans what real talk means. Beat it. Next question.
I've heard of you. Now, I didn't know I'd ever meet you, but ladies and gentlemen, this is Anderson Silva's fan.
What did you do with the money you won off of Amanda Nunes, by the way?
Actually, I just parlayed it into me kicking Chael's ass.
Yeah, everything in that photo about Tito with that ticket, except Tito. I could have sent out that same ticket. You really think Tito Ortiz put $55,000 on Amanda Nunes? Come on, man. No.
Okay, final question for
you
Scott.
You were a little speechless on that.
Yeah, a little bit speechless
on
that.
Did I just break it to you that there's something out there called Photoshop?
I think everybody's starting to believe your lies now. Finally, your lies aren't becoming truth, huh, buddy?
Go, Tito.
Yeah, yeah. I've been ready to go for the last week.
Like now, though.
Yes, like right now, like now. But you know what? I'm cool. I'm professional. I've been doing this for 20 years.
Classy.
I'll step back and I'll wait until Saturday. I'm okay.
Tell another jackal story about Christopher Walken and a mane and a lion and you and Vitor from back in the day.
You know, when I jump out of that airplane, I don't want to be positive that chute's going to open.
You don't? You don't?
I don't.
What do you mean you don't?
Well, if you can't understand it, you can't sit in my shoes, brother. A lot of guys can be fighters, but only one can be champion. And maybe I'm wired a little bit differently, but that's the way it goes.
You tapped. I saw you tap. I couldn't believe that I saw you tap because you were crushing him for four rounds, but you tapped. I saw it.
Well, it seems to be a misunderstanding and a misapplication of the rule process. I thought, like, if somebody had you in a tight hold, you could just, like, rub his leg a couple times and your tag team partner, you know, would step in there and help out a little bit. And then they bring me to and they try to explain the rules. And there was, like, some kind of confusion. And he ended up getting his hand raised in an extremely tainted victory. But as I said, the real champion sits before you today, undefeated and undisputed.
Tito's car just got repossessed a week ago. Tito has a Rolls Royce. Now, in fairness, that's a beautiful car. I wouldn't own one because I'm not that big of a prick.
Guys, I was at Craft Services with Tito a little bit ago. I threw an orange at his head. It stopped a foot before his head and started circling it like an orbit.
I heard that he tried to sell some suits to make do on the car, but nobody had a size 52 stupid.
Every time he opens his mouth, I sit back. I should just call you Dum Dum. You haven't even been hit that many times. And back when you were on top, everybody else sucked too. You know, it was a contest to see who sucks the least. I have no explanation for why the things that come out of his mouth come out of his mouth, or how they're meant to be, or if they're promotion, or if he's just a dummy. What was your question?
Why are you asking questions in English? Anderson sits here like he doesn't understand you. Ed Soros interprets, and we got to hear it a second time. First off, he speaks English, and second, we could replace Ed Soros with an app I could download for $9.99. What kind of bizarro world are we in here? This is the strangest thing I've been part of. You know, people ask me if I wanted to go to Brazil for the fight. Sure, it'd be neutral territory. Anderson lives in a mansion in Beverly Hills. Las Vegas, Nevada is closer to him than it is to Westland, Oregon. He's got home court advantage. What are we even doing here, guys? This is insanity. He sits over and pretends he doesn't speak English? Come on. It's like pretending you're the world champion. I can't believe... Guy walks around with a fake belt. That's insane. I would never do that. Oh, boo. Oh, he went too far with the fake belt. Come on. Have you guys been...
Listen, man, his record speaks for itself. He's a good, durable fighter. He's the champion, but I am the best. And there can be only one, and I'm not going to make any apologies for that. You know, and he's done a good, solid job. He's a durable guy. I'm a world-class athlete. He's a martial artist. I'm a cage fighter, and there's a tremendous difference. And on Saturday night, it's going to be one more in the win column, one more for the highlight reel, and one more for the bad guy.